Start. Hello student, now we will see the IC565 as PLL. Phase lock loop, PLL, okay. The function of the phase lock loop circuit is to provide a lock in terms of the frequency and the phase. Okay, so this PLL circuit, when you are not applying the input signal, when no input signal is applied, then according to the resistance and according to the capacitor selected, this will give the output called as the free running frequency FO and the output voltage V0. So the output of the PLL is free running frequency, and this free running frequency is like this. So this is my output voltage V0. It is generating some frequency F0. Okay. So when no input is generated, here the frequency F0 is automatically here generated. Okay. Now I want to make the PLL circuit. What the PLL says? PLL says that output frequency must be equal to the input frequency. Now suppose I apply the input. This input is not equal to 0, but I have to apply the input as a square wave. Okay. So adjust this amplitude so that the internal circuit will activate. So keep the Vi equals to maximum. Apply the input frequency Fi. Apply the input frequency Fi, and from this Fi we will get the FO. Okay. What happens in the PLL? When the no input is applied, the your output is at the pre-running condition, that is the FO. So your input is here, input frequency is here, your FO is here. This is called as the pre-running condition. When your input is applied, then the difference between the FO and the FS is decreases, and the error voltage is increases. Okay. So as this difference is reduces, the error voltage changes, the VCO frequency, VCO voltage changes. So VCO frequency changes. So difference between FO minus FS is go on decreasing. One point will come when the output frequency becomes equal to input frequency. So the point where the output frequency becomes equal to input frequency, it is called as the lock. It is called as the lock. For example, I apply the input signal equals to 1 kHz, and by this circuit, my output frequency is also equals to 1 kHz. So output comes out to be 1 kHz, and input is also comes out to be 1 kHz. What he says? He says that once it is locked, if you vary the input frequency, your output frequency will also follow. Okay. So here my output frequency, here my input frequency. If my input frequency is 1 kHz, when my input frequency is 1 kHz, I am getting the output equals to 1 kHz. This is called as the lock. Once it is locked, if you reduce the frequency below 1 kHz, suppose 500 Hz, okay, 1 kHz, 900, 800, 700, 500. So 500 Hz, I will find that this is the 500 Hz. Beyond 1K, I increase it. 1.1 kHz, output will be 1.1 kHz. 1.2 kHz, output will be 1.2 kHz. Suppose I make it 1.5 kHz, my output is also 1.5 kHz. Okay. So if you vary the frequency from 500 Hz to the 1.5 kHz, after locking at 1 kHz, you will find output also follows the input. Okay. But below 500, as soon as it becomes a 490, then output is not equals to 490. Similarly, if it is 1.6 kHz, your output is not equals to this. It means that it follows during this much portion. So this range of frequency over which the lock is maintained is called as locking range. 500 Hz to 1.6K is called as the locking range. Okay. Now we will see this setup on the CRO. We will vary the input frequency. So as I vary the input frequency, the output will also vary. So this is IC565 as a PLL.
Here the input frequency square wave is applied. Here by selecting the capacitor C or the resistance R, the VCO output is obtained. This VCO output is obtained as this one. Okay, so this is my VCO output. When suppose I remove the input, my VCO frequency is somewhat different. It is other than this. But as soon as when I apply the signal and now I set up it, our top side is the input side. As the input frequency varies, the output frequency will also vary. Okay. So first of all, I will have to maintain a lock. See here. Now it is locked. This is the frequency, input frequency. This is the output frequency. Now I decrease it. So lower is also decreased. My frequency is 590 hertz. Output is also 590 hertz. As I again decrease it, my frequency is the 521. My output is also see, as the input frequency is locked, as input varies, output varies. So if it increases, this is also changes. Now the lock is open. I reduce it. See here, by varying the input waveform, the output waveform will also get locked. Okay. But it will continue up to what? Only in the lock range. So now I increase it. What is my frequency? It's 528. How much it is? 618. Now my input frequency is 649, but my output is different. It means that lock is open. Lock is open. Repeat it at the lower side. My input is 421. So input 421, output 421. Below that 395, lock is open. So somewhat around 420 to around the 620, as the input frequency varies, output is also varied. That is called as the lock, and the system is called as phase lock loop. So see here, by varying the input frequency, the output is get locked, and output follows the input frequency. This is called as the IC565 as PLL experiment. Thank you.